Hello everybody from the UN headquarters in New York, where the first senior level meeting, or SLM, of the Global Partnership for Effective Development Cooperation is being held on the theme of addressing how we work together for more sustainable development outcomes. Today we are in conversation with real stalwarts. I have with me Marita Gonzalez, Monica Novello, who are both co-chairs of CPDE, and also we have Anibal Cabrera to complete the trio, who is the regional coordinator for CPDE from Latin America. Marita, what is CPDE's advocacy? I do not understand Spanish, and Marita speaks that most beautiful language. So Monica has agreed to kindly translate whatever Marita says.
Bueno, una de las tareas que hace el CPD dentro del Senior Level Meeting está vinculado a desarrollar un partenariado mucho más inclusivo, mucho más democrático, mucho más horizontal con las organizaciones de la sociedad civil, pero también en diálogo con los gobiernos para poder hacer que la cooperación sea más eficaz y particularmente más participativa y con apropiación democrática, rendición de cuentas.
Marita was telling us that one of the tasks that and aims that CPD is promoting here in the SLM is to try to get into the discussion of sustainable development, the issue of inclusive dialogue, inclusive partnerships with all the multi-stakeholders that are part of the global partnership. We believe in a very horizontal dialogue between the actors, and that's what we are bringing into the discussion and in this space.
Monica, what do you have to say about CPDE?
There's a lot of things that we have to bring into the conversation. One of the issues that we are trying to advocate for is to get the governments into discussion of how important is to build an enabling environment for CSOs to do the work as actors of development. We have been recognized, I mean the CSOs, civil society organizations, we've been recognized as development actors on our own on our own right, and then what we are doing is trying to build a proper space in which we can do our work. We are in some countries, what we do is to cover the spaces that the states cannot reach. So we are trying to improve livelihoods of women and people, children, and so on. So we believe we have our own word to put on the table to discuss how can we be more effective in this moment that we are trying to accomplish a very complicated and committed agenda, which is the Agenda 2030.
Okay. Anibal, what is your take on this?
How is
advocacy being done or advanced in Latin America?
¿Cómo está haciendo el trabajo de incidencia en América Latina?
Bueno, el trabajo de incidencia en América Latina es un trabajo complejo debido a que nuestras democracias y los gobiernos están en crisis en muchos países. Hay conflicto y fragilidad en Honduras, en Nicaragua, en Venezuela, en Brasil, en Colombia, y eso hace que el ejercicio de advocacy en los temas de desarrollo sean complicados.
Anibal was referring to the complex context of America Latina, especially in some countries as Nicaragua, Honduras, which has a context of conflict and fragility. And most of our countries have a democratic crisis, and which is a very crucial issue. Especially if we are talking about CSO engagement in the development.
Sin embargo, hemos trabajado fuertemente en la participación de la sociedad civil en el Foro de Desarrollo de América Latina, en CEPAL, y hemos logrado tener un mecanismo de participación ciudadana después de muchos años en un foro político a nivel regional en Naciones Unidas.
In America Latina, we have been participating in the ECLAC Sustainable Development Forum, in which we've been engaging and committing from a Latin America perspective. We didn't have been engaging in this kind of process, so this is very important for us as CSOs in Latin America.
Okay, so my next question again is, and I think Marita will answer it first, how is the CPED harnessing or using civil society to promote sustainable development?
Bueno, nuestra organización de la sociedad civil para la eficacia del desarrollo promueve básicamente la Agenda 2030, sobre todo en todos los objetivos de los problemas más sistémicos que hay a nivel mundial. Esos problemas sistémicos vinculan lo económico, lo social, lo cultural y básicamente con todas las organizaciones de las cuales somos parte.
Well, what we are doing is trying to get an approach of the sustainable development from a systemic analysis, which includes not only economic issues, but also political and social issues. And we are trying to push to put some of these issues in the agenda on the effective development, but also because when we are trying to and this is mine, not Marita,
yes,
but
okay. Yes.
This is my addition,
yes.
Which is but also because I think this is a very good opportunity in which not only the effective development cooperation agenda and the 2030 agenda are merging right now. So I think finally the sustainable agenda and the 2030 agenda is picking some inputs from the discussion that we have been pushing from CPD perspective in the development discussion, and especially this moment, I think it's not only physically that we are in New York, but also we are trying to commit commit to the 2030 agenda and the sustainable development from the effectiveness agenda. I think we need to think that we need to push for the 2030 agenda and all the goals, but especially we need to think that we need to more effective if we want to get the agenda accomplished.
Annabelle, what would you like?
¿Qué quisieras agregar a lo que dije de cómo se están fusionando ambas agendas?
Creo que el desafío que tenemos entre la Agenda de Efectividad y la Agenda 2030 es pensar que finalmente eso impacta en la vida de las personas y las comunidades. Y no dejar a nadie atrás significa poder poner a las personas en el centro de las acciones, de todas las agendas. Y creo que ese es el desafío que como sociedad civil venimos diciéndole a los gobiernos y a las diferentes partes interesadas.
Aníbal was adding that from the effectiveness agenda and sustainable development agenda, what we cannot forget is that we are talking about changing lives and changing concrete lives of people, not people that we see every day and the communities. And this is a very strong effort that CPD is doing to bring that into the discussion. It's not only about development, but it's about changing concrete livelihoods of people and communities.
So that no one is left behind.
And that's one of the things that he said strongly. I think if we really don't want to leave no one behind, then we need to take into account that we are talking about people. What sort of support do civil society organizations need at the moment or in the current times so that they fulfill this role to help in sustainable development? What sort of support do they need?
¿Qué apoyo necesitamos como sociedad civil?
El primer apoyo que nosotros necesitamos es el propio empoderamiento de la propia sociedad civil, que cada uno de nosotros sepamos que contamos con un hermano o con una hermana al lado apoyándonos en el trabajo. El segundo, digamos, creo que la sociedad civil tiene esa capacidad. El segundo apoyo es poder tener una mejor vinculación con los organismos de Naciones Unidas que están vinculadas al desarrollo, porque es la forma de que efectivamente la Agenda 2030 sea una realidad y no solamente una declaración de principios de los gobiernos. Y en tercer lugar, el apoyo que necesitamos está más vinculado a que el financiamiento para el desarrollo vaya realmente a los países más necesitados y sobre todo a los países en fragilidad.
Me too. Remember if I forget something.
Yes.
Marita was telling us that the first thing is to recognize that we are from civil society is not alone. We are different stakeholders from civil society, and we need to support each other. The second one was
multilateral.
Oh yeah, and the relationship between civil society organizations and the governments, because we are here to remind their commitments, and we need to be sure that this is not only rhetoric, but it's put in place some action, concrete actions, in order to push for sustainable development. And the third one is
multilateral, las organizaciones multilaterales de las Naciones Unidas.
And the commitment of the governments in a space as the United Nations, taking into account that the multilateralism is a commitment of our governments, not only donor countries, but all governments.
Yes, what about
you? Yeah, well, I think when you talk about being more effective, we need to create the adequate conditions for civil society to operate. And this is about enabling environment. And what we know is that in most countries of this world, we are facing a kind of trends in which some civil society organizations, human rights defenders are facing some troubles, are accused and persecuted by being vocal and denouncing the human rights violations. So what we need to assure is a good space in which we can, as civil society, accomplish our tasks. The other thing that I think is very important is to assure that we can access a civil society to funding for our work. And sometimes most of the countries are supporting directly the governments, but they forgot to support also civil society activities.
Creo que lo principal que necesitamos las organizaciones de la sociedad civil es que nos reconozcan como actores principales del desarrollo y que nos dejen de matar en todo el mundo. Hay muchos activistas y defensores de derechos humanos que son perseguidos, criminalizados y son asesinados en distintas partes del mundo, y es tiempo que los gobiernos y las organizaciones internacionales como Naciones Unidas pongan mayor atención a eso. Lo otro es que hacemos un trabajo muy fuerte de llevar la voz de la diversidad a los distintos espacios de trabajo a nivel global, y eso también tiene que ser reconocido.
We need to get governments recognition of the role civil society has to play in this context. And Aníbal was pointing out that in some countries human rights defender activists are persecuted and
he asks strongly about stop killing us as civil society advocates. So this is an issue that has to be raised, and we need this is a good space. And the because some of the activities that civil society representatives are doing is under it's accused of being criminal activity. So this is a way in criminalizing activism. So this is one issue. And the second one, ¿cuál es el segundo?
La diversidad.
Oh, yeah, about diversity of voices that we bring into this kind of spaces. Civil society is a wide platform. The CPD is a wide platform in which we are representing some organizations and the diversity of the civil society, and we are trying to bring some voices here. So we believe that the governments can listen to us and can listen the voices of people who actually are not here but are here because we are here.
Thank you very much. Thanks to all three of you, Marita, Monica, Annabel, and double thanks to Monica for translating such a beautiful, beautiful language to make it understandable to a person like me. And I hope I learn the language someday to be able to understand.
I come from a very diverse country, and we have 36 different languages in Bolivia. The indigenous people who actually talks in different languages, and they like to say that we borrow Spanish in order to understand to each other. So this time we are borrowing English in order to understand each other.
So that is just unity in diversity, and that is also what development is about, to include everyone. Language, no barrier. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank
you. I hope it was useful.
Thanks. Nice to meet you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.